Hello everyone, in physics classes we are doing first unit of class 12, that is electrostatics, and we are doing the topic Gauss law and its applications. Two applications we have already discussed. One is to find out electricity due to a uniformly charged spherical shell. Second is to find out electric field intensity due to a solid sphere. And today we are going to discuss the third one application of the Gauss law, that is to find out the electric field intensity due to a thin infinite plate sheet of charge. This curve is showing that this sheet is extended up to infinity. It is very thin, means its thickness is negligible as compared to its size, and it is positively charged. So we are going to find out electric field intensity due to this sheet. Let's start with the definition of Gauss law. According to the Gauss law, we know that electric flux is given by total charge upon epsilon naught, and this is E, electric field intensity. Ds is the small area. Okay, we are every time choosing a small area by choosing a Gaussian surface. Now for this sheet, firstly, we need to choose a Gaussian surface, as we are doing in the previous topics also. Okay, we can't imagine a sphere. Why? Because this sheet is of infinite size. Okay, so we are considering, suppose this position, like, why? Because it is a positively charged and its thickness is very, very thin. Due to positive charge, electric field intensity is in this direction. If I am looking at this side, then electric field intensity is on this side. Because electric field intensity from a positive charge is in the outward direction. So this one will be the electric field intensity's direction. Okay. Gaussian surface I am going to imagine that will be a small cylinder of cross-sectional area ds. I am choosing a Gaussian surface as a cylinder which is having its ends exactly equal, at equal distance from the center of sheet. If this is the center of sheet as well as of the cylinder, and suppose this distance is r and this is also r, and our observation point we can consider on this side or at this side. So I want to find out electric field intensity due to the sheet. That's why I have chosen Gaussian surface, cylindrical in shape. Why we are not choosing spherical, as we have chosen in previous topics? Because the sheet is of infinite size. Okay, so to get a finite shape, because we need to find out area, na, the stuff. So I am choosing a symmetric cylinder which is symmetric on both the sides of the sheet. Okay, now if I am talking about these two ends, suppose this end is P and this end is Q. At this end, N vector is showing its area vector. At this side also, N vector is showing its area vector. Also, we have already discussed the direction of electric field intensity. So electric field intensity is in this direction, here in this direction. If I talk about the curved surface of the cylinder, then area vector will be given by in this direction. We know area vector is a normal, is a perpendicular drawn on the surface towards the observer. If observer is observing from upper side, okay, so it will be a perpendicular in this direction. If someone is observing it downward, then it will be in this direction. Now, angle between electric field intensity and this area vector is 0 degree. For this case, this one is the area vector and this one is the electric field intensity. So theta is equals to 90 degree. Again, for this direction, electric field intensity is here and area vector is in this direction. So theta will be 90 degree. And in this direction, area vector and electric field intensity are in same direction. So theta is equals to 0 degree. And we know when we open this dot product, we get cos theta. and cos 90 is 0 and cos 0 is 1. So these terms do not contribute anything to calculate the flux or electric field intensity. So when I am opting this for various position, I get the electric flux or electric field intensity due to these two ends only. For other points, the direction of electric field and area vector are perpendicular to each other. And when theta is 90, then cos 90 is 0. So I can write it as E ds cos theta is equals to q upon epsilon naught. Okay, now cos theta, it is valid for P end and Q end, these two ends only. So I will write it as E into A plus E into A. Or if I have taken the area ds, so directly we will write E into ds plus E into ds. E will remain same on the left hand side and on the right hand side both. Why? Because this is a uniformly charged sheet. So electric field intensity here or here, it will be same on both the sides. And we have chosen a Gaussian surface which is also symmetric. So area of P point and Q point both are same. So for this left hand side, I get these two equations, these two terms, E dot ds, E dot ds. Angle is 0 degree, so cos 0 is 1. So EDS plus EDS is equals to Q upon epsilon naught. Because we have a infinite sheet, so we will talk about its surface charge density. Surface charge density we have already discussed, that is given by charge per unit area. Surface charge density is charge per unit area. If I want to find out charge, it will be given by sigma into PDS. I can write this thing. Because this is a uniformly charged infinite thin sheet, so I am discussing about the term surface charge density. That is given by charge per unit area. Its unit will be coulomb per meter square. Okay. From this equation, if I want to calculate charge, it will be given by sigma into ds. This thing I can replace here. EDS plus EDS, it will be 2 into EDS is equals to sigma into ds upon epsilon naught. Now this ds will be cancelled out and E will be given by sigma. This 2 will shift here in the denominator. 2 upon epsilon naught. E is given by sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. Epsilon naught, the absolute permittivity of the air of the free space, and sigma is the surface charge density. This is electric field intensity, and you can see this is independent of the position, means this distance r is not considered. So we can choose this cylinder of shorter length or of longer length, it will remain same. So whenever if we are having a uniformly charged sheet, thin sheet of infinite size, having surface charge density is charge per unit area, then its electric field intensity will be given by sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. I hope this is clear to you. This thing we consider infinite sheet. Suppose now I am saying ki if I have finite sheet. Finite sheet means its size is going to be finite. Then this equation is not going to be true for all the points. If this sheet is of the finite size, not infinite, then this equation is valid for only the points which are near to its center. If we are considering any point near about its edges, then it is not going to be true. Suppose this is a thin sheet. Okay, don't imagine its thickness. Just imagine it is a thin sheet. If I want to calculate electric field intensity here, near its center, then this equation is going to be valid. If I am calculating electric field intensity near its edges, then this equation will not be valid. This is valid for the sheets which are of infinite size. For finite size, it is valid for few positions, not for the all positions. And for infinite size, it is valid for all the positions. Okay, now I have taken electric field intensity due to two thin infinite parallel sheets of the charge. Suppose the sheet is also positively charged and this one is also positively charged. The same case is here. Here we were having one sheet and now I am having two sheets. Okay, so electric field intensity due to first sheet will be E1 and electric field intensity due to second sheet is E2. Suppose its charge density is sigma 1 and its charge density is sigma 2. Now I can say E1 is equals to sigma 1 upon 2 epsilon naught and E2 will be given by sigma 2 upon 2 epsilon naught, because we have derived the result for it that electric field intensity due to an infinite charge sheet is given by sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So this will be the electric field intensity due to these two sheets. Both are positively charged. Suppose I want to draw the direction of electric field intensity due to first sheet. Here it will given by E1. And in this direction it will given by E1. Here also E1. Because it is a positively charged sheet, electric field lines are outward from this sheet. Now if I want to draw the electric field intensity direction due to E2, due to sheet 2. So it will be the direction of E2. Here it will be the direction of E2 and here also it will be the direction of E2. It is again outward. The only thing is that positive charge is having electric field in the direction away from it. So E1 here away from this, here away from this E1. For this E2 away from E2, away from the sheet 2. So now we have three reasons. First reason, second reason and third reason. First and third reasons are the extreme positions outside from the sheets and second reason is the in-between reason between the sheets. Okay, now we will find out net electric field due to presence of two sheets in all the three reasons. Reason first, reason second and reason third. We are going to find out the net electric field. This was the electric field due to single sheet. And this one is for the two sheets. Okay. Now electric field intensity is having this direction, both the directions have. So we need to consider, we need to apply some sign conventions that one direction we need to take positive and another we need to take negative. Because you can see that in first, second and third reasons, electric field intensity in this direction and in this both are present. So for sign conventions, definitely we need to choose some convention. What are these? We are habitual for reading, for writing from left to right. The same we are applying. If we are moving in the right direction, we are taking it positive. And if we are moving in left direction, we are taking it negative. Because in both the direction they are present now. So directions are opposite to each other. If we are considering it positive, then this one will be negative. If we are considering this negative, this positive, then that will be in the negative. So we have fixed this. If we are moving in the right hand side, then we are taking positive direction. If we are moving towards the left hand side, then we are taking its negative direction. So for reason first, E in reason first, how I can calculate? Both are in same direction. We are going to add them, but because they are in left hand side, so we will take negative. So it will be minus E1 minus E2 minus sigma 1 upon 2 epsilon naught minus sigma 2 upon 2 epsilon naught, or I can take common minus 1 by 2 epsilon naught sigma 1 plus sigma 2. This one be the electric field intensity in first reason. Now in second reason, E2. E1 is towards the right hand side. E2 is towards the left hand side. So I will write I1 minus I2. Sorry, E1 minus E2. E1 is sigma 1 upon 2 epsilon naught. E2 is sigma 2 upon 2 epsilon naught. am taking common 1 by 2 epsilon naught. In the bracket, it will be sigma 1 minus sigma 2. This will be the net electric field intensity in between the sheets. E3, both E1 and E2 are towards the right hand side. So we will take them positive, E1 plus E2. I am directly writing 1 upon 2 epsilon naught sigma 1 plus sigma 2. So these are the electric field intensity in various regions. Okay. Now from this one, E1 and E3, 1 by 2 epsilon naught sigma 1 plus sigma 2, both are same. The only difference is negative sign. And that is clearly visible in this portion, electric field intensity due to both sheet towards right hand side. In this region, electric field intensity in the towards the left hand side. And the magnitude will remain same. And in between, they both have opposite directions. Right hand side we are taking positive and left hand side we are taking negative. So these are the electric field intensity in E1, E2 and E3 region. Why we are doing this? Because of numericals. We should know the result, this one only. That due to an infinite plane sheet of charge, electric field intensity is given by E is equals to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. And that result we are using to find out the electric field intensity due to presence of two parallel sheets. They are present parallel to each other. Okay. So we get these results. Now we are applying special cases. What are those special cases? Suppose the sheets which we are choosing, they have same surface charge density. Sigma 1 is equals to sigma 2 is equals to sigma. Okay. What we are saying? Ki suppose both the sheets are having same surface charge density. Means charge per unit area is the same for first sheet as well as for second sheet as well as for third sheet. If we are having third sheet. Okay. Sigma 1 is equals to sigma 2 is equals to sigma. Second thing I am saying ki first sheet is having positive charge and second sheet is having negative charge. Okay. So I can write sigma 1 is equals to plus sigma and sigma 2 is equals to minus sigma. Charge per unit area density is the same, but only the thing is ki their charges are opposite. First is for positive charge, second is for negative charge. So our diagram will be like this. I am showing their size finite, but no, we are doing the topic infinite. So just for the means paper diagrams, we are drawing them like this. You can draw here zigzag lines so that it is showing ki these are infinite shapes. Their size is of infinite order. Okay. So this one is positive. This one is negative. Its surface charge density is plus sigma. And its surface charge density is minus sigma. Reason 1, reason 2 and reason 3. We have already calculated. That is the general. In numericals you will get the condition. Both are positive. Both are negative. One is positive. One is negative. Like this. Okay. So E1 is equals to minus 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught sigma 1 plus sigma 2. Now putting these values, sigma minus sigma. Minus 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught, 0. Means here electric field intensity is 0. Similarly E3, this is positive. This term was negative and this one is positive. Sigma minus sigma, again 0. Result you can use from here. E1 and E3. Okay, now E2. E2 is 1 upon 2 pi epsilon naught, 2 epsilon naught, sigma 1 minus sigma 2. If I put the values, 1 by 2 epsilon naught, sigma 1 is positive sigma and sigma 2 is negative sigma. So this both negative will make the positive. One negative is here and second is sigma 2 is minus sigma. Okay, so it will be positive. Positive, positive will add up and we will get 2 sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. So E2 is equals to sigma upon epsilon naught. that E1 was sigma by 2 epsilon naught, E2 was sigma 2 by 2 epsilon naught, and this one is the twice of that. You can say it is of the order twice of that. Means electric field intensity is here 0, here it is also 0, here non-zero value, and that is sigma upon epsilon naught. When we have two parallel sheets of opposite charges, one is positive and second is negative charge density, okay, and they have same charge density, only the sign difference is different, one is positive, one is negative, and their magnitude sigma is equals to Q upon A, charge per unit area, their magnitude is same, okay. So we get the result at the center only, that is sigma upon epsilon naught, and at their ends we do not have any electric field intensity. So whenever we need electric field somewhere, this arrangement we are going to use. What we will do? We will do two oppositely charged thin parallel sheets like this. Like this. So here and here electric field intensity is zero, but in between electric field intensity is present, and that is given by sigma upon epsilon naught, charge density upon epsilon naught. So this one, this arrangement we are going to use whenever, wherever we need the presence of electric field intensity. So this was the topic, electric field intensity due to thin infinite plane sheet of charge, for one sheet and for two sheets having different charge density, then these formulas we are going to use. Having same charge density and opposite, then we are going to this one. So this one is the general result which you can apply for different numericals according to the given statement. I hope this concept is clear to you. For today, this is